Well, welcome to this fantastic occasion. Graduations are one of the highlights in the academic calendar. Unfortunately, we have a slight bit of rain this morning. I'm hoping it will be off by the end of the ceremony, because we really want to do an academic procession from here up to the Learning and Teaching Building, but we'll be getting the thumbs up or the thumbs down at the end of the ceremony, whether or not we're able to do that, depending on weather. So welcome to everyone. I know we have international students and their families here coming from across the globe. Welcome to the campus, to the Barony Hall, which is one of our feature pieces, I guess, of the campus and of the Glasgow landscape. A fantastic building, truly fitting of today's ceremony. Today's ceremony is going to involve our graduands coming up onto the stage, and in front of me, we will then cap them. And capping is a tradition that goes back to the Scottish Enlightenment, where we confer the degree and they become graduates. After that, as I say, we'll walk up to, we'll have an academic procession, hopefully moving up to the teaching and, or sorry, the Learning and Teaching Building. After the capping ceremony, I will say a few short-ish words about the university, but for now, I formally declare the ceremony open. Oh, and one last thing, a very serious point. This is a day of celebration. So let's make a little bit of noise when you hear your loved one, your family member coming up on stage. Don't be shy. This is a place to be animated and show your appreciation for them getting their degrees. Thank you.
Executive Dean, in the name of the University and by the authority of Senate, I present to you these students for the degree of Doctor of Philosophy for research in the Department of Computer and Information Sciences, Aisha Rashid Ali Al-Badi. Mohammed Abu Bakr Al Hassan. Fatima Al Hayyan. Mohammed Amin Belabiz. Cheryl Canning. Maria Christina Martin. Dominika Michalkova. Zuzana Pinkosova. Ryan Shaw. For the degree of Master of Science in Advanced Computer Science, Samuel Anderson. Anish Naresh Buktani. Tanu Prasanna Bijapur. Matthew A. Cornetto. Amir Hossein Farajpur Tabrizi. Brijesh Krishnakant Gandhi. Foroh Genatsor. Mohammed Arslan Idris. Yeah. Puneet Kapoor. Mohamed Mohammed Hussein Hassan. Sabarish Babu Murugesan. Gopinath Nilappally Ashwartredi. Chaitanya Patak. Kartika Rajan. Pavitran Rajan. Richa Rashthod. Omka Manohar Shinde. Shubham. Dhruv Nilesh Solanki. Sweta Raj Valia Vitil. Harika Radamadu. Nilima Yaramadu. In advanced computer science with artificial intelligence, Shafiq Kakundunban Manayil. In advanced software engineering, Emmanuel Birifiafe Jaffet. Rajesh Singh. Sanat Kumar Singh. Amanullah Sumro. In artificial intelligence and applications, Sai Swarup Reddy Batula. Mark Donaghy. Ravina Ramesh Suhagia. In cybersecurity, Andrew Cooper. Rebecca Sarah Megan Enyon. Martin J. Gray. Alan John Henderson. Jennifer Kay. Shanice Rachel Macho. John Norman McKenzie. Shannon Elizabeth Milligan. Paul Matthew Shand. Ankita Tandon. In digital health systems, Purujit Srinivasan. In Information and Library Studies, Antonietta Colasante. Ekaterina Tikhonova. In Information Management, Shalom Onasegi Oriaki. For the degree of Master of Engineering in Computer Science, Gergely Janos Batori. Amy Nicole Begbie. Dylan Burns. Matthew Galbraith. Hope Greenshields. Abinmon Jane. Reese Charles Jones. Radina Kryova. Colin Roy McFarlane. Benjamin David McPherson. Harris Mahmoud. Bertrand Jean Dominic Angelo McLean. James Alexander McGregor. Ludvikus Nemiro. Neve Ann Spratt. Alina Varkey. For the degree of Bachelor of Science in Computer Science, Suleiman Ali Akhtar. John Neil Lopez Batista. Callum Daniel Clark. Paul Craig. Lewis McPherson Danby. Tim Enos. Sam Guy Hunter. Zoltan Kiss. Alexandra Kliaugeiter. Alessandro Lecas. Michaela Luzzi. Ryan McDonald. Eamon Connell McClay. Liam McGloin. Nathan McKittrick. Ross Peffers. Adrian Pilgren. Thomas Rampley. Kieran Michael George Stephen. James Thomas Tierney. Magdalena Valentinova Veleva. Ross Michael Walker. Jack David Blair. Mackie John Burgess. Donald Colston. Joshua Cameron Doughty. Ramsey Ediku. Zinab El Alami El Felous. Lucas Alexander Graham. Luke Green. Nathaniel Joshi. Andrew Charles Robert Lawther. Stuart David Grant Lindsay. Callum Marshall. Mark Stephen McCafferty. Sean Francis McGeechee. Scott Morton. James Lang Norwood. Michael Parker. Thomas George Irvin Ralston. Saeed Ali Saeed Saka Al-Kabi. Ibrahim Safdar. Eamon Spence. Georgia Strachan. Ethan Thomas Young. Nasser Bada M. Al-Khaldi. Andrea Caraggia. Ewan Hamill. Jack Archibald Hartley. Owen Hepburn. Abu Bakar Khan. Christos Kringou. David McNamara. Fergus Alexander Rutherford. Luke Andrew Spears. Carmen Tsang. Lubomir Rozenovtsenkov. Cameron Whaley. Luke Campbell. Satoshi Usami. In software engineering, Krasimir Krasimirov Balchev. Samuel Max John Birchmore. Enrique Martin Ocaña. Faye Paulina. Aaron Gerard Savage. For the degree of Bachelor of Science in Computer Science, Naya Alexandra Morton. In software engineering, Max Duffy. For the degree of Master of Science in Advanced Software Engineering, Shahid Hussain.
Well, congratulations, everyone. Well done. I think after a couple of years of lockdown, they deserve a bit more than that. Let's hear it again. So that was better. Well done. And congratulations to all of our graduates. It's a really special day for you and for your family and friends, marking the culmination of several years of hard work and dedication. We've thanked the graduates, or we've applauded the graduates, but for them to get here today They've had to show great resilience, adaptability, determination, and we've had a number of challenges, as I've just mentioned, pandemic. But students don't work alone. They need the support of their friends, their families, their loved ones. It's a great moment of pride for them to see their family, their offspring perhaps, standing on stage. So let's take a moment, students and staff, to applaud the friends and family who've supported the students to get here today. And the other category of people who might need some thanks are not the extras from Harry Potter, but they're actually our academic staff who are sitting on stage in their various colours, indicating where they received their degrees from. But they've played a really crucial role in the journey for the students. Dedication, working tirelessly, giving an exceptional education and a student experience. So students and family, let's thank our staff. Okay, they're all offering broomstick flying lessons later as well. Once we've concluded this ceremony, we will leave the hall, hopefully in an academic procession. I can't tell what the weather's doing at this point in time, signifying that the graduates will now become full members of the academic community, which numbers almost 200,000 graduates now worldwide. As esteemed members of this community, you will join a long line of distinguished alumni such as David Livingston, John Logie Baird, Dame Eilish Angelini, Helen Liddell, and Sir Tom Hunter. Strathclyde was formed in 1796 during the Scottish Enlightenment through the bequest of Professor John Anderson, who is one of the leading figures in the period of Enlightenment and hailing the need for knowledge and education. And he believed that knowledge was for the greater good, and he wished to establish a place of useful learning, which is the University of Strathclyde today. We have remained faithful to this founding principle, and it continues to guide us as we strive to make a positive impact on society and the world. We are a research-intensive university committed to creating new knowledge and understanding to tackle the challenges of our time. Through our groundbreaking research, we're contributing to a better world. And I'm not just saying that without any evidence. In the recent Research Excellence Framework in 2021, the UK's government system for assessing research quality, almost 90% of Strathclyde's research was assessed as world-leading or internationally excellent. We also had the second highest impact profile in Scotland, demonstrating the effect our research has on everyday lives in the real world. Our research and our impact is wide-ranging. Our scientists and researchers are leading the development of innovative technologies that will facilitate the transition from fossil fuels to the clean, sustainable energy sources such as wind, solar, and hydrogen. This will power our future world and tackle climate change. We're developing new drugs using new digital manufacturing processes, and these will provide cheaper, more effective treatments in the fight against cancer, kidney disease, and inflammatory diseases, whilst also helping our health services evolve to face the challenges of health and social care in the changing demographics of the 21st century. Through our focus on entrepreneurial education, Strathclyde Inspire, we're helping students and staff to create new businesses with sustainability in mind and creating jobs and supporting economic growth. In fact, in a recent survey and an article, Strathclyde was ranked fourth in the UK in terms of its contribution to the spin-out activities in the UK, just behind Oxford, Cambridge and Edinburgh. So we're really doing quite well in terms of our innovations. We're leading the revitalisation of this part of the city through Glasgow City Innovation District. We're bringing companies, both large and small, to work together with the university to create new ideas, technologies and solutions to a range of problems across key research clusters. And you may have seen the Scottish Innovation Strategy was released recently, featuring clusters, and they mirror a lot of the clusters which we are working on here at Strathclyde, including health tech, fintech, 5G, industrial informatics, space and quantum technologies. And much of this is housed within our Technology and Innovation Centre, which is down on George Street. In the near future, we're going to build another innovation centre named in honour of one of our most successful alumni, businessman Dr. Charles Wang, and he was the CEO of the company which produced the lateral flow tests, which were used extensively during the pandemic. As an alumni, he recognised the role that Strathclyde had played in his success, and he donated £50 million to the university, an extremely generous gift and our largest ever in our history. We're growing Scotland's manufacturing capabilities as part of the fourth industrial revolution, Industry 4.0. We'll see digitalisation, automation and artificial intelligence transform the sector and provide huge economic and employment opportunities. And much of this work is taking place in the Advanced Manufacturing Innovation District near Glasgow Airport, where the National Manufacturing Institute for Scotland, operated by Strathclyde, is being opened right now by the First Minister. And if you look out of the windows of the aeroplane when you're maybe taking off or landing, you'll see the big purple building at the side of the runway, which is the National Manufacturing Institute. And next to that is the Medicines Manufacturing Innovation Centre, where Strathclyde is also a major partner. We're working to inform public policy on national economic strategy, education, productivity, and workplace strategies through our various research institutes. And through our Centre for Sustainable Development, our globally minded staff and students are working to co-create solutions with our global partners across academia, the civil society, and the public and private sectors to secure real-world impact and tackle the United Nations Sustainable Development Goals. And in pursuing our vision, we understand the value of successfully working in partnership with business, government, and the third sector to make a difference, and we extend our global reach through academic partnerships with the likes of Stanford, NYU, MIT, Caltech, Tsinghua, Nanyang Technological University, University of Waterloo, and the National University of Singapore, to name but a few. As a university, we are continually working to enhance our student experience. We're investing in our campus and student experience, as evidenced by our new Strathclyde Sport and our teaching and learning building, which we'll be visiting later, and investing in health and wellbeing services. And we're always trying to put students at the heart of everything that we do. Our progress and efforts in all of these areas has been greatly recognised in recent years with a host of awards. We became the only university to win the Times Higher Education UK University of the Year twice, first in 2012 and again in 2019. We've also been named Business School of the Year, Workplace of the Year, and have received the Award of Research Project of the Year in recent times. Now, today we're graduating from Computer and Information Sciences, so I just want to share with you some highlights from the Faculty of Science and also from the from CIS. So we've got some researchers in CIS who are developing an app for people to help look after someone living with dementia, and this should help them engage in regular physical activity. And according to Carers UK, 75% of carers in Scotland said they had suffered mental ill health as a result of caring, while 81% of carers for all ages in the UK said they were not able to engage in as much physical activity as they'd like. So this app should really be quite a good technological aid to those carers in these challenging situations. Professor Fen Dong from CIS has led a team which has successfully secured funding to deliver novel causal counterfacial visualization techniques and collect evidence for the role in causal decision support in a real-world clinical setting. And he's working with clinicians across Glasgow. And Dr. William Waits has secured a grant from the Medical Research Council to develop rules-based and epidemic models, rule-based models that combine a transparent modeling approach with scalability and compositionality to facilitate the study of aspects of infectious disease propagation in a richer context than would otherwise be feasible. And this is really important in the post-COVID era. These are just a few small examples of activities which are ongoing in the recent few months. There are many more, but we don't have time to go into those. But it's important to reflect on our achievements, because it's on these past achievements that we build our future. And today is a day to look forward to the beginning of a new chapter in your lives, where you'll take the knowledge and skills you've acquired during your time here to pursue and realise your ambitions. And as you forge your new careers, the university's values of being people, of being people-orientated, ambitious, bold, innovative, and collaborative will stand you in good stead. And in recent years, while the world has been shaken by the coronavirus, the cost of living crisis, and the armed conflict, not least of all the war taking place on our own continent, continues to create uncertainties in life. And we have to tackle the biggest challenge of all, it's our climate emergency. These challenges demand solutions, and as graduates of Strathclyde and the future leaders of our society, you have a responsibility to use your talents and your education to make a positive impact on the world. Whether you go on to pursue careers in business, science, engineering, politics, or any other field, remember that you have the power to affect change, to inspire others, and to shape the course of history. But with great power comes great responsibility. You must never lose sight of the values that have guided you thus far: integrity, humility, and empathy. These are qualities that will set you apart as you navigate the challenges and opportunities that lie ahead. And as you step out into the world, you carry with you the knowledge and skills that you've acquired during your time at this esteemed institution. But more than that, you carry the spirit of Strathclyde, a spirit of innovation, collaboration, and excellence. And you go out into the world equipped with that most valuable asset, knowledge. The Strathclyde degree you now hold in your hands is your passport to success as you rise to meet the challenges ahead. And as you embark on this new chapter of your lives, I encourage you to continue learning. Embrace new challenges. Remember that the pursuit of knowledge is a lifelong journey, and that success is measured by what you achieve and also the impact that you make on the world around you. So it's with immense pride that we see you graduate today, and though you may be leaving us, some of you will, some of you may be staying on for further degrees, we hope you'll continue to stay in touch and do let us know how you get on and continue to contribute to Strathclyde. So in conclusion, I'd like to congratulate you all once again on this momentous achievement. The University of Strathclyde has equipped you with tools you need to thrive in the years ahead, and I have no doubt you will make us proud. So go forth with confidence, with purpose, and with the knowledge that you're capable of great things. Thank you very much. Okay, I've been given the thumbs up for the procession. So, the academic grouping will leave the stage, followed by the students out of the hall, and then we'll turn right as I'm looking at it, maybe left as you're sitting down, and we'll walk up towards the Learning and Teaching Building, where there'll be a reception to join and celebrate with the students and graduates. So I now formally declare this ceremony closed, and thank you very much once again.